is up, dudes and ladies? Here we have a Cloudlifter. We just got this in. This is the CL-2, called the mic activator. It's basically a small preamp that works well for dynamic microphones, especially, let me see if I can grab it here, you know, like larger broadcast style microphones or ribbon microphones. So just going to unbox it here. I'll have more of a demo in the next video. So let's see what's in the box here whenever you buy one of these things here. All right. Boom. Cloudlifter. Got a user guide. What is this? Magnet. What else we got? So here's the unit. This, again, is the CL-2. Most of the time you're seeing the CL-1s in a lot of the videos. Of course, the CL-2 is going to have two different inputs there, and that looks like that's everything. Yep, that's everything in the box, guys. That is it. So there is our Cloudlifter. Also, zoom out a bit. Got a couple of smaller, shorter XLR cables, so that way I can use it on a tabletop close to our audio interface, and I won't have like a 10-foot or 15-foot XLR cable between these two. So grabbed a couple of those. Also grabbed a Shure SM7b. It's on back order right now, so there will be videos about that. But in the next video, we will actually test this out, and I'll probably use the Rode Procaster, at least for now, because the Procaster, of course, needs a lot of gain. I'll be using it with the Complete Audio 6. And what the Cloudlifter does, basically, is it runs off of, again, it's like a preamp, but it runs off of the phantom power of your audio interface versus, you know, being something that you plug into a wall. But it's like a small mic preamp, except it doesn't have any tubes. It doesn't have any controls at all. So it's going to give you what's called clean gain. Okay. And the idea is it can boost the output of your low output microphones, like our Procaster or like our SM7B or the RE20, for example. It boosts that signal. So then you don't have to drive your preamp either on your interface or even onto a mic pre as hard as you would have to, which sometimes that can pull noise in. Again, I'll have a full demo on this later on. So it's basically like, you can almost think of it as like a preamp, right? If you want to think of it like that. Anyway, here's the instructions. You also do get a warranty registration card in there as well. Maybe you can read that. And the user guide, just hold that up right there. Basic stuff, up to 25 dB of clean, quiet, extra gain, which can be useful for a lot of microphones that do better, maybe without the colorization that you might get with certain tube preamps or other kinds of preamps. It's, you know, it's kind of expensive and kind of not expensive at the same time. It's about, this is unit here is $250 here. The single is like $150, which, you know, it's not overly expensive for what it does. It makes your microphones more sensitive, especially, again, our broadcast microphones, such as, again, the Rode Procaster here, which takes a ton of gain that a lot of audio interfaces, you know, personal audio interfaces, can't really drive that well without, at least without taking the gain all the way up. The Complete Audio 6 will drive the Procaster if you take the gain all the way up. And the preamps in the Complete Audio 6 are rather clean. It's all right, but still, I prefer to use, at least currently, I prefer to use the Procaster with a Zoom H6, which I'd show it right now, but I'm using it to record with, because the Zoom H6 has a ton of gain. Of course, the problem is you start really pulling that gain up, you can start getting sort of the sound of those preamps, maybe some noise in the signal. So that's what that's basically what a Cloudlifter is for, to give you clean gain. It's a, you know, it's a great unit as far as build construction goes. Okay, so that is what's in the box of our Cloudlifter CL-2. Again, the next video we'll actually demo this thing. We'll plug it in with our Complete Audio 6 and test it out with the Rode Procaster in this case, because my SM7b is still on back order. No.